here with Alex Gabbay discussing his recently released film, which I had the pleasure of seeing the other day, Just Trial and Error, Conversations About Consciousness, and specifically the role of art and science in consciousness. So we're going to talk about art and science. And the fundamental question is how they differ, how are they in some ways the same, what qualities do they share, and which do they definitely not share?
I think what I learned in the process of making the film is that there are quite a lot of similarities between art and science, in that art investigates, explores the meaning of life, making sense of the world, and science does the same. The difference may be that one of the things that we sort of stumbled on is that perhaps science tries to construe it in such a way that it sees itself outside the thing it's studying, whereas I don't think art tries to make that distinction.
So science attempts, if I understand correctly, that science in what you learned and in your view tends to be or tries to be objective. It removes the observer from what is being observed, which of course totally fails in quantum mechanics, as we know.
Yeah.
But aside from that, that's at least a mindset. Mm-hmm. Whereas in art, there's a melding of the creator and the created, something like that.
Very much so. I think that we had two scientists in the film. One was Bo Lotto, who's a perceptual neuroscientist, and one was Brian Butterworth, who's a cognitive neuroscientist. And I think both would agree that neuroscience is nowhere near, understanding consciousness. I'm not sure whether art would possibly be closer to understanding or to expressing what consciousness is in different forms. I think that it's going to be quite a long time before neuroscience actually really understands consciousness.
I couldn't agree more. And I think the reason for that agreement on my part is that art really does seek to kind of have an empathic relationship between creator and viewer. The emotion that is instantiated in the artwork is designed to hopefully recreate that experience in the viewer.
Yeah.
Well, that's very different than if you're trying to analyze and rationally communicate properties of something, which is kind of what science is about.
Yeah, I think Brian, I can't remember the quote exactly, but it was something like, how does the mind which has no was it something like that? How does that has no matter?
How does consciousness which has no matter emerge from matter?
Yes, exactly. Perfect. Yeah. And I think that's the sort of dichotomy, that's the problem. How do you solve that one? Whereas I think art doesn't try.
I understand that. Even if it's conceptual art, nonetheless, it's more primal in some ways. It's more immediate. It's more visceral, even if it is conceptual or digital. Whereas at the other end of the spectrum, the holistic nature of what is being analyzed is not really the question. Yes, there's the astronomy picture of the day, where you can see incredibly beautiful images taken from the cosmic space, outer space. But the analysis is in the realm of individual spectrums of light or gas, which is really quite different from the object that's giving those off.
So I think in that sense that what neuroscience is leading towards is looking at relationships rather than breaking down into sort of units. It's more about how does this work with this, but at the same time it can work with that, but this changes, you know, the meaning if it works this way rather than that way. So it's trying to work with relationships, I think, and this is something that art is doing naturally. You see what I mean?
I see. I do. Yeah, I do. So then in terms of meaning, meaning might be found in relationships between components of a system rather than breaking down the components of a system to smaller and smaller bits.
Yeah, I think so.
That's a very interesting proposition.
Yeah.
The other thing that comes to mind is emotion versus reason in the two realms.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of parallel to what we just talked about, but a slightly different tack, in that it's possible to analyze a piece, and art critics do it all the time. But even then, it's very qualitative. It's not, unless you're looking at a particular form of scientific analysis of the medium that's used in a creation, it's still very, very qualitative.
Yeah.
Whereas qualitative gets in the way of science.
Well, it's interesting that you've picked up on this, because that's one of the big points in the film that we've tried to bring across, is that the sort of development of man has been very much based on a numerative, quantitative basis. We've learned to value what we can actually quantify. And
right.
The qualitative side is lagging behind, perhaps. And I think, in a way, this is the big difference between art and science. Art doesn't really rely on the quantitative, unless we're talking about selling it. And then science, obviously, you know, totally relies on the quantitative. So I think the idea of bringing relationships in takes away so much from quantitative. It's more about qualitative in a way. I don't know.
I hear that. It occurred to me while you were talking that one of the bridges in the other direction is when, mm-hmm. For example, there's a kind of an annual competition now, mm-hmm. put out by the Academy, mm-hmm. The American Association for the Advancement of Science, that Academy. And it's about data visualization. And mm. some of the images that come out of that can
really?
Only be described as beautiful,
yeah.
as artwork, even right. though they're based on data points. So that's moving in the other
yeah.
directions, which reminds me, perhaps a way to sum all this up is what I consider a beautifully succinct quote. It's not an exact quote, because I can't remember it exactly, but it's pretty much a quote from Edward O. Wilson in his book, Consilience, where he states, again, very briefly, very elegantly to my mind, that art is about transmitting emotional content. Science is about explaining it.